Outlines are often used in games as a style choice or to highlight and select objects. Godot makes it really easy to make simple outlines without having to touch even a single line of shader code. We'll start by making a simple outline and upgrade it to remove a few common problems. Then we'll be using that outline to highlight and select objects, and finally show how to display objects behind walls. Here we have our simple character. First, let's hide its armor so we can focus on the character mesh. Select the mesh node and create a new material overlay, standard material. This overlay material is applied on top of the mesh's original material. We are going to use this to make our outline. Open the Grow tab and enable Grow. This will expand the size of the mesh, making it grow outwards. Let's set it to 0.03, so it is slightly bigger than the original mesh. Then open the transparency and change the cool mode to front. Now the scale-up mesh will only render the back faces of the mesh, which so happens make it look like an outline. This technique is called inverted hole, and is very commonly used to make outlines. Next, open the shading tab, and set the shading mode to unshaded, so it doesn't get affected by light and shadows. Now we get a very crisp, white outline. But take a closer look at the shadows. If we disable our grow, you'll see that the outline mesh is generating shadows, which is not ideal. To fix that, you can set the blend mode to pre-multiplied alpha. Now our outline doesn't cast shadows anymore. With our outline material done, let's save it so we can use it for other objects. Click on the material arrow and select Save As, and let's save it as Simple Outline. Having done that, let's unhide the other meshes, and drag in our outline material to each of their material overlay slots to give them outlines as well. But here's where we start seeing a common problem with the outline. If we take a closer look at the sword and shield, the outlines doesn't look correct. The outline material have disconnected faces, and the results are very bad. If your models are using flat shading, you'll start to see those problems too. That's a limitation of the grow shader, as it uses the faces normal to grow the mesh. Take a look at these cubes. One uses flat shading, and the other one smooth shading. The grow shader will use the normal vector, those purple lines, to calculate where each vertex will spin towards. In the smooth one, each vertex point have the same vector, and everything works fine. But in the flat one, we have the normals pointing to different directions, which makes the grow material separate the faces. There are a couple ways we can solve this, but the simplest solution is to use weighted normals. Let's do that to our shield. Simply select the mesh and add a weighted normal modifier. This will take the average normal vector between faces and convert them. You can increase its weight to get a more flat look. It gives us a look similar to flat shading while keeping the normals together. If we apply this modifier, we can now see a single purple line per vertex, which is what we want. So let's see how that works inside the game. Let's take our new shield and add our outline material again. Much better. Now we don't have gaps and our outlines are looking nice. And here's what it looks like when applied to every mesh. Now we have a nice looking outlines for our character. But there is still one problem. The outline does not have a fixed size, and that might be fine for style outlines. But when using outlines for selecting objects, it would be nice to have the outline width to be the same size no matter how far the object is. Also, you can easily change the outline color by changing the material's albedo color, so we can have black outlines for a better style. There is this great article about outlines that explains very well how outline works, and how we can make the outline have a constant width size. Luckily, someone already converted it to Godot in Godot shaders. So we can just look for the pixel-perfect outline shader and copy this code. Let's remove our simple outline and create a new shader material. Open it and create a new shader named Perfect Outline Shader. Hit Create and click on the slot to open its code. Now, select everything and paste the Perfect Outline Shader's code here. You can open the Shader's parameter section to configure the outline. We can set its desired line size or change its color. And now, no matter how close or far away the camera is, the outline line width will be the same size, which is especially useful for showing interactable objects. So let's save this new material as outline material and use it to create a mouse over highlight feature. But before that, let me talk about the sponsor of this video, Brilliant. Brilliant is an online platform that helps you learn and think with interactive problem-solving exercises and lessons. It is a great tool for reviewing and cementing math concepts that are quite useful for games. Take the vectors course for example. It has a very intuitive collection of lessons with lots of usual representations and feedback for what is happening that can really help you understand how things work. It is packed full of interesting courses that can guide you in learning new things, including beginner lessons to start learning game logic and more advanced coding lessons with Python. Brilliant also gives you lots of feedback for completing lessons that can help you feel motivated to do daily lessons and not give up. If you think that is for you and want to try it out, you can head off to brilliant.org/octodemy to get yourself a free 30 days free trial, as well as a 20% discount off your annual membership subscription. Now let's go back and highlight some objects. Let's use this bush. First, we need a physics body to detect the mouse over collision. One quick way to do that is to select the mesh, and using the mesh menu, select Create Collider Shape and select Static Body Child. Next, create a script and let's name it Select Highlight. Here we will add an export variable for the mesh that will receive the outline and the outline material itself. Then we are going to use the physics body mouse enter and mouse exit signals to detect our mouse. When the mouse is over the object, we simply set our overlay material to the outline material, and when it exits, we just remove it. Then we drag in the mesh and the outline material. Let's add the outline material so we can visualize what it's going to look like. And let's change its color back to white so we can see it better in the distance. Now when we mouse over the bush, it will add outlines. But let's make some change to allow our script to actually select objects. Drag the outline back again so we can see it. And let's save this as a new material named Select Material. This will be used when the object is selected. Create a next pass standard material. The next pass material is applied on top of the outline. Let's go over to transparency and enable alpha transparency so we can see it. And change its albedo color to a nice selection color with some alpha. I'm going to use a light cyan color for selection here. So when our object is selected, this is what it's going to look like. Now let's remove it and update our script. We are going to add a new selection material export variable and a selected boolean variable. And then add the input event signal from our physics body. Inside here, we are going to check if there is a mouse click event that happens when the mouse is over the object. If there is, we just flip the selected value and update our material. If it is selected, we set our selected material, otherwise, we just use the normal outline. Simple as that. Finally, we also need to update our mouse enter and exit functions to only update the outline if the object is not selected. Then we make sure our materials are properly set up, and we now have a nice way to select objects with highlights. We can click them to select them, and click again to deselect. We can also make this script easier to use in other objects with a small change. Here, I added an export variable for the physics body and manually connect the signals in the ready function. Now you just need to add the select highlight script to a node, plug in the mesh and materials, and done! A very easy and fast way to highlight and select objects. For the last part, let's make our objects show behind walls, making an xray material. First, let's take our character's simple outline material, make it unique, and save it as a new material named xray outline. To make an xray material in Godot is actually very simple too. And for that, we are going to add a next pass material to our outline. This is the material that is going to be visible when the character is behind objects. Let's open the transparency and check the node depth test. This will make it so the material is always visible. Now we only need to make it not appear on top of the original colors. To do that, we are going to need to change our base material. So let's open our mesh and copy our surface material. Then paste it into Material Override so we can change its properties. We only need to change a single option here. Open Transparency and change it to Depth Prepass. Now the X-ray material is only shown when it's behind the tree. That happens because of how Godot handles transparent objects. It first renders all the opaque objects and then starts rendering the transparent ones. And because both of our materials are technically transparent, the original material can be rendered on top of the X-ray one. But because it doesn't render behind the tree, we see our X-ray color that is drawn behind that. But we still have a problem. If we move the camera a bit, the X-ray can be seen instead of the base material. That's because Godot doesn't know what material to render first. we want to make sure that the base material is always rendered on top. So let's open our xray outline again and change its render priority. We want our outline to always be at the back, so let's set its priority to -2. And set our xray material render priority to -1. This way, Godot will always render the materials correctly. You can also change how the xray is displayed, so let's give it a reddish color. But the outlines are not visible behind the tree yet. To fix that, just add the no depth test options to it. And now everything is looking good. The character is visible behind objects and has some very nice outlines. But what if we want to use this xray to an object that has several meshes? Go into every single mesh to copy its material just so we can change its transparency can be a lot of manual work. There is a better way to do that. So we are going to create an import script for our models. Create a new script that inherits from editor scene post script. This allows us to tell Godot how to import our models. You can check on how it works on this video. But here's the simple script. It goes over the imported object and looks for mesh instance 3D nodes. When we find one, we simply set its transparency to alpha depth prepass. So if we take a look at this wizard model, we can see it has no transparency in its imported material. We select the model and go to the import tab. Under import script, select the script we just created and hit re-import. Now all the materials have the alpha depth prepass option that we needed. We don't have to override the material for our xray effect anymore. Here's how easy it is to set up a mood mesh character. Select all the meshes together and set its overlay material to our xray shader. Then open the models import tab, select our import script and re-import the model. And now it's working. We just need to add the outline to the remaining armor pieces. Select all of them and set their overlay material. And there you go! A very nice outline mood mesh character that is also visible behind walls. Now you can create beautiful outlines for your game's objects. Use them to highlight interactable objects and select them. And also use an xray material to display behind other objects and walls. I hope you liked this video. Thanks for watching. And until next time.